Okay, now we are in stage 5 of the stake pool operator journey, and now we need to register a stake pool to the Cardano Foundation. In order to do that, let's open GitHub for the Cardano Foundation. So let's go there. You see, we are in the Cardano Foundation user and the incentivized testnet stake pool registry right here. And the process involves us creating a fork of this repository, like this fork. So you fork here, select your username, and then it starts to fork. Perfect. You got the fork in your account. You see now it's in my username. Oh, no, it's incentivized stake pool registry. And I got the fork. Let me get my GitHub username written down here because I will need it. And now we can clone or fork of the repository. So git clone your username and the name of the repository you want to fork, which is in my case this one. It's forked. It's now cloned on my local machine. And now we need to create the registry JSON file. Let me show you how that file looks. So, in order to register your stake pool, you need to create a JSON file that has the following fields: an owner, which is your public key, the name of your stake pool, in my case is called example stake pool, a ticker, which is 3 to 5 letters that represent your stake pool, a little bit of a description, this is an example for a tutorial, the homepage of your stake pool, and the pledge address of your stake pool, which we have already because we created the account. So once you have this data, you should create a JSON file like looks like this, but you know, with the correct information for your case. And you save the file. And the name which you save it with should be also your public key. So let me show you. In my case, I'm going to use, you are going to save it in my local directory, incentivized testnet stake pool registry, which is, you know, the clone of Git that I did. In the registry folder, and the name is going to be my public key with a .json file right there. So I do that. Okay. That's not enough. Now I have created one file. I now need to create, let me show you how it looks for my case. For my case, this is my owner, public key, and my pledge address, which is my account. Okay. And now I need my private key saved in an owner.prb file. This is because the next command requires the private key stored in a file, in a text file. So I'm creating this little text file. The way you would do it is, you know, with your text editor, you would use something like your text editor, copy your public key here, and save it as owner.prb. Which is this one right here. I'm just using the command line. And now that I have that, with GCLI, I can do k sign my secret key in a file, in a text file, like this. And then I want the output to stay on this file, but with the signature extension. And what the file that I want to sign is the JSON file that I created before. Okay? So let's go over. I move my private key to another .private file. I just saved it there. Then, using the keysign command from GCLI, as parameter, I use the owner private file that I created here as the secret key. I want to set the output designed file here, which is, you know, in registry public key signature. And the file that I want to sign is the one that is the JSON file that I created, you know, above. Okay? Hope that's not very confusing. And now I have signed it. Now, let me show you that I actually have in the registry folder two files. The one that is my JSON file with my public key, and the one that is my signed file, again with my public key but with a .signat.sig extension. Now that I have both files, I can move to change the directory to there and git add that file git add the next file and now we do a git commit with the ticker of our stake pool, git commit dash m example, and now it's committed. Now we do a git push. Now that's the git push, we can go to GitHub, and here we can see, if I download this, you can see that I have 17 commits, and I can go ahead and do a new pull request and create pull request, and here they are going to see my pull request, and then I'm going to be added to the Cardano registry. That way my stake pool is going to appear in the Dedalus and Yoroi user interfaces as an approved stake pool. Very cool, right? We have finished stage 5. We have registered our stake pool to the Cardano Foundation. We just need to wait for them to approve our stake pool.